If there was an engine configuration that came directly off Formula One, it has to be the V10 engine. It may not have originated from the sport, but it certainly came into the sport for this very configuration alone. When Formula One regulations were open on engine configuration, it created a difference between Formula One cars. The difference was less cylinder engines were larger per cylinder to meet the regulation's cubic capacity limit compared to the more number of cylinder engines with smaller per cylinder. The smaller per cylinder also allowed them to rev the engine even more, so it could produce even more power through higher RPM. This led to lesser cylinder engines having better torque, while those with more cylinders getting better top end power, with the latter being known as power engines. Generally, it was V8 engines versus 12 cylinder or 16 cylinder engines. The advantages of the 8-cylinder engine at the time was that it was less of a challenge in packaging for engine and its ancillaries. Its weight advantage was not simply isolated to the engine being physically lighter, but the 8-cylinder engines were also more fuel efficient, meaning they carried less fuel load, meaning less weight. Horsepower, however, has always been an advantage in Formula One. For this very reason, some teams choose a configuration that could produce more of it. There were 12-cylinder engines and the 16-cylinder engines. When turbocharging was introduced into Formula One, they were immediately categorized as power engines for having similar traits that these engines consume a lot of fuel because they could make so much power and were not good on slow and tight circuits because of turbo lag. High fuel consumption also means more weight, yeah? The turbo engines were also like other power engines in that they were not as reliable as the 8-cylinder engines.
Gordon Murray, your cars are second and fourth on the grid with Nelson Piquet and Riccardo Patrese. What do you think is your chance of a victory in tomorrow's race?
I think from a speed point of view we have a chance, but from a reliability point of view I think we'd be very lucky to have even one car finish, because it's a very new car and engine combination.
In fact, you switched from the Cosworth engine last year to the BMW engine turbocharged, which is a completely new kind of technology for you, isn't it?
It makes things a lot more complicated, yes, fitting the engine in and all the bits and pieces that go with a turbocharged engine.
These power engines were dominant in high-speed racing circuits that are known as power tracks.
It's the end of qualifying here at Kyle Army. Behind me in the pit lane, the mechanics are hard at work. And that is a welcome sight, because the 1982 South African Grand Prix is a race that almost didn't take place. We expected a battle during qualifying between the three top turbo teams, Ferrari, Renault, and Brabham with the new turbocharged BMW engine. And sure enough, that's exactly what we got. At the end of today's shortened qualifying period, we have René Arnoux on pole position in the Renault with a time of 1 minute 6 seconds, 0.35. Close behind him is world champion Nelson Piquet with a time of 1 minute 6 seconds, 0.62. And third fastest with a time of 1 minute 7.11 seconds is Canadian Gilles Villeneuve with the turbo Ferrari.
The engines that brought about more nimble traits fared a lot better in the slower, tighter circuits. When turbocharging was banned, this left the 12-cylinder engines to compete with the 8-cylinder engines. There were also a host of different racing circuits with different characters that suited these different engines. The intermediary of these circuits gave Formula One engineers a natural choice to decide on fusing the two engines together. A power engine with a torque band similar to a V8 engine. Hence born the V10 engine, straight out of Formula One. It also improved packaging and was lighter than the 12-cylinder engines, so technically it would be an all-round Formula One engine. Ironically, the first V10 engine for Formula One never competed in this category. It was an Alfa Romeo engine known as the Tipo 1035, 10 being the number of cylinders and 35 for 3.5 liters. It was built in 1986. The engine is basically fusing two 5-cylinder engines into a V configuration. dividing 720 degree for a 4-stroke engine by 10 cylinders has an even firing order V10 engine inherent a 72 degree V angle. It was known to be very smooth for cancelling out primary and secondary balance order. Because the cylinders at either end are not evenly timed, having a 72 degree offset, the V10 engine is known to have a slight wobble to it. Crank timing 1 and 5 is in a different angle. To reduce this wobble, the V10 is designed with crank timing 2 and 4 to wobble opposing crank 1 and 5. Because it is not at the end of the crankshaft, this means the torque to its wobble is not as great due to the reduced leverage, so the wobble is still there but reduced. Lexus further counters this on their 1LR GUE by using two inner crank timing that are neighboring the outer cranks to counter the outer crank balances. Then there is that setup on the Dodge V10 engine, a V8 engine with an additional crank pin for two more cylinders that are at a 90 degree bank angle. There is also resorting to using a counterbalancer shaft. One thing the V10 engine is popular for is its unique sound. A mix of throbbing sounds of a 5-cylinder, but with a high-pitched racy exhaust note when the two banks of cylinders combine. The follow-up to this is also running two 5-into-1 exhaust extractors.
We really don't know. We didn't get any long runs yesterday. Oh, that sound is just so good, man. I mean, oh, it's the greatest sound of a racing car ever. What? I hate that they got rid of it.
Engine manufacturers also tend to experiment the V10 engine with changes to its V angle. Usually this is done to further lower center of gravity from 72 degree to 90 degree. When Formula 1 regulations confined the engines to V10, Renault Sport even experimented with 112 degrees. The split double 5-cylinder allows such versatility. An engine manufacturer that builds a variety of V10 engines is Judd. They have engines ranging from 4 litres to 5.5 litres, all 72 degree lightweight racing V10 engines. Notable V10 engines that are on production cars is Lexus's 1LR GUE, Porsche's 980/01 or M80/01, which has a narrow 68 degree V angle, BMW's S85 B50, which is a 90 degree V10 engine, and the V10 engines shared by Audi and Lamborghini. One of the earliest proposals for using a V10 engine on a road car was a Gandini-designed Lamborghini concept known as the P140. This was way back in 1988 and manifested itself to a concept car that is known as the Kala, which was designed by Giugiaro. The first production car to have a V10 engine was the Dodge Viper in 1991.